These two questions we're going to do together because they both ask about the graph, but not the passage. So question 9 asks, data in the graph about per pound coffee profits in Tanzania most strongly support which of the following statements? And then there are a bunch of different interpretations of what the graph means. And then question 10 asks, data in the graph indicate that the greatest difference between per pound profits from fair trade coffee and those from regular coffee occurred during which period? So let's do question 9 first. And then before we really look at the questions, let's just pop over to the graph real quick and see if anything leaps out at us. All right, so here's the graph. The dotted line represents fair trade coffee. The unbroken line represents regular coffee. The y-axis here going up and down is the dollar amount or cents per pound of profit. And then the x-axis going horizontally is the year. Now, the broken line, fair trade coffee, is always above regular coffee. So it looks like fair trade coffee always made more profit than regular coffee did between the years of 2000 and 2008. The two lines don't cross, and it seems like fair trade coffee's profit remains pretty stable, whereas regular coffee's profit seems to wiggle a little bit. So let's go back over to question 9 and see what we're being asked here. So, option A, fair trade coffee consistently earned greater profits than regular coffee earned. That feels like it's supported in the graph, right? The broken line is higher, is making more money than the unbroken line. So that could be our key. That could be our answer. But let's keep going and see if we can knock out the rest. The profits earned from regular coffee did not fluctuate. That's not true. We looked at it and we saw that it was kind of moving around. The price of regular coffee did kind of fluctuate. Fair trade coffee profits increased between 2004 and 2006. I don't know, let me go check. But fair trade and regular coffee were earning equal profits by 2008. We know that's not true because the lines never cross. Now let's go back to the graph really quickly and see if there was any increase between 2004 and 2006. There's 2004, there's 2006, and that is a straight line. So no, they did not increase. Okay, so fair trade coffee consistently earned greater profits than regular coffee earned. Cool. So all I did there was look at the graph and figure out the story that the data were telling. And when that story conflicted with the choices, I knocked them out. Meanwhile, let's move on to question 10. So this is about the greatest difference between per pound profits from fair trade coffee and regular coffee. And in fact, during our question survey phase, I already marked this period. It seems like it falls between. And that's the period between 2002 and 2004, because that's the period when the distance between these two points is the greatest for. So let's see if 2002 to 2004 is an option. Choice A, that's 2000 to 2002. Choice B, 2002 to 2004. There we go. 4 to 5, 6 to 8. There you go. So all I did there was, again, the same strategy. I identified the precise thing that we're looking for in the question stem, which is looking for the greatest difference between per pound profits. And then I went back to the graph and pulled that interpretation out.